TIFO is delighted to offer 30-day free trials to read the work of our colleagues at The Athletic, the new home of football writing. José Mathias is the most sought-after property in Mexican football. Last season, he scored 12 goals in 26 appearances for Club León in the Apertura, and then back at his parent club, Guadalajara, after he was recalled from his loan. He scored 0.58 goals per 90 for Guadalajara and 0.51 per 90 for León, 0.39 if penalties are removed. He was also ninth of all players, not just the ones that we looked at in Liga MX, for goals per 90 and shots on target per 90. Mathias looks to find space by bending runs around the wrong side of defenders, curving away from the side that the ball is on and into the defender's blind spot. He's also adept at movement in the penalty area, backing away from the goal if the defence drops back too much so that he can find space. He's intelligent enough to know where a good opportunity is likely to find him. Now, as a finisher, Mathias has an extraordinary ability to dig out enough room to shoot. His movement generally takes him away from defenders, but even if they try to crowd him out, he seems able to find a way to guide a shot on the target. He possesses good control, and while he generally finishes quickly from counter-attacks or crosses, he's got the ability to take the ball on himself through skillful dribbling. He also has the shooting skill to compensate for the occasional heavy first touch, and manages to generate power from a low back lift if needed, or guide the ball into the far corner of the goal. His finishing is excellent. His link-up play is good rather than exceptional, and while he's quick, he doesn't generate most of his chances through pure pace, but rather through the intelligence of his runs or positioning. He's reasonably good in the air, although consistent across both his clubs is that he's a focal point for passes that serves his runs rather than aerial balls. As a striking prospect, he looks to have everything to succeed at a top club. Monterrey boast two excellent young players, Montes and defensive midfielder Jonathan Gonzalez, while midfielder Carlos Rodriguez is also a talent. But with Sebastián Vegas recently moving from Morelia to Mazatlán, Montes is the outstanding young centre-back in Liga MX who might be for sale. He's a right-sided centre-half in Monterrey's back four. At 1.95 m, he's physically imposing and boasted a 60% success rate for his six aerial duels per 90 last season. Defensively, his game is sound. He makes 9 successful defensive actions per 90, as well as 7.6 interceptions per 90 adjusted for opposition possession. His timing is good in the tackle, accruing only 1 yellow card last season in almost 2,000 minutes played. And his passing is accomplished too, with 8.5 progressive passes and 5.8 passes into the final third last season, both per 90. He's best at drilling short or medium length passes low up the pitch, as his longer passing can be overhit. But he occasionally finds a good length to release Monterrey's right-sided attackers. He moves well across the ground, especially when covering deep or across, and he looks like a relaxed and confident player. His ability to turn with the ball at feet looks a little laboured at times, but he carries it forwards well enough before looking to pass forwards. His first-time clearances can seem a little too relaxed at times, giving the ball straight back to the opposition, but this is also because when he clears, he looks to find a teammate rather than just hoofing it forwards. His size is generally beneficial. He's a nuisance at attacking set pieces and can generally hold players up when defending through his body positioning alone. When he does give away fouls, it's often because he's leaned too much into a player who then goes down. But in a physical league, his bulk will generally be an advantage. Uruguayan attacking midfielder Leonardo Fernandez has yet to appear for his parent club. But last season, he managed 8 goals and 2 assists in just over 800 minutes on loan at Toluca. His contract with Tigres is in place until 2024, but they'd be unlikely to resist a large offer. Hernandez has played in the hole in a 4-4-1-1 and featured in both wide positions of a 4-2-3-1. The predominantly left-footed player, he can also strike it well with his right, as his goal against Querétaro in March showed. He likes to drop off too, finding central positions from which he can play long passes into the channels. In advanced areas, he's capable of sliding through passes to on-running players or playing quick balls to find overlapping runs. His passing metrics are impressive, with 0.63 key passes, 1.2 deep completed passes, and 0.83 deep completed crosses, as well as 6.3 progressive passes all per 90. He's also a capable ball carrier, with 5.6 dribbles per 90 at 57% and 2.9 progressive runs, which are runs where a player gains 30 metres towards the opposition goal. He's skillful too, and his quick feet mean that when receiving the ball under pressure, he's able to move it on before being closed down too much. He also seems to be a player who wants to run the game, constantly showing for it and moving into positions in which he can receive the ball. Fernandes is not great in the air, as might be expected, and he sometimes seems keener to protect himself by going down rather than standing up to a tackle, but for a smaller creative player, this is perhaps understandable. He wins quite a few free kicks and has himself got an excellent set-piece delivery, both from corners and free kicks. Whether he'll start to get substantial game time at his parent club remains to be seen, but Fernandes could develop into a very strong creative talent. Versatile Roberto Alvarado usually plays either as an attacking midfielder or an inverted right winger, but he's also lined up as a left winger and a central midfielder. Cruz Azul use a variety of formations, and Alvarado's ability to play across various positions has certainly been an asset. Last season, Alvarado scored 4 goals and registered 6 assists. He's hard to pigeonhole, not quite a pure number 10 because he's too good out wide, but constantly looking to come inside, so not really a winger either. He even drops deep to help out defensively and prompt attacks with longer range passing. Alvarado is very left-footed, which explains his drift inside from right-hand positions, but even as a left winger, he likes to cut inside and use his dribbling ability. 4.9 dribbles at 53% success and 2 progressive runs per 90 last season, and also use his passing to create from central areas. He does also possess the ability to cross, especially standing deeper balls up towards the far post, but he's most creative sliding through balls along the ground. Last season, he managed 0.56 key passes per 90 and 5.6 progressive passes per 90. He's great at receiving the ball in space and immediately releasing a pass or carrying it in field from the right and then changing the angle of attack. Alvarado is also capable of excellent moments of skill. His first goal of a brace against Tijuana in March was a scooped lob from outside the area. The second, a lovely side-footed shot on the run with his weaker right foot into the far corner. He's still prone to doing too much with the ball sometimes, carrying it further than he should and losing it, and his versatility could mean that it's hard to know exactly where he's best. He also needs to work on his defensive game. But Alvarado is a genuine attacking talent with a high ceiling, good enough to play for a top side in Europe should he continue his development. It's scouting week at TIFO, and to celebrate, we're offering 30-day free trials to The Athletic, where you can really get under the hood of your team. With dedicated journalists for every Premier League team and correspondents for La Liga, the Bundesliga, and Serie A, not to mention hundreds of journalists for 10 other sports, there is no better place to read comprehensively about your favourite teams. See the link in the description to sign up for free now for 30 days and join TIFO at The Athletic.